Hello, I'm back. This is Ann Beauregard, Ward 5 City Councilor, and you're watching Ward 5 in 10, a monthly segment that we do to try to keep people informed of what's happening in Ward 5 and throughout the city. I am the Ward 5 City Councilor. Today is Friday. Unbelievable already, November 16th. We've seen snow. It's cold. It gets dark out early, and we're in for a long one, I believe. I can be reached at 774-297-4939 or at abeauregard@cobma.us. All right, let's see. We have a whole lot to go on here. First of all, I want to mention that, as I said, today is right before Thanksgiving. We want to thank our veterans and all they've done for us. And we want to thank those that are serving in other parts of the world for our freedom. As, they make many sacrifices, and those, before them have made many sacrifices. We also want to commend everyone that voted. More people voted than many years in the past, and we're very excited, and let's keep this momentum going. And your vote matters. And look at what's going on in Florida, for example. So I speak from experience myself. We're getting ready for Thanksgiving. We know that some people have some concerns, and we want to continue to emphasize the fact that there are many services in the city of Brockton when people are in need, and they serve the residents of Brockton and many other communities that don't have support services like that in their towns. So again, I cannot emphasize that there are people around to help. Feel free to call me, 774-297-4939. I don't have all the answers, but I can certainly let you know about where you can get services, and we'll try to help you navigate the situation. As I mentioned, in a week from now, Thanksgiving will actually be over. We hope you have a wonderful, safe Thanksgiving. But you might be joining us at the holiday parade on Saturday, November 24th. This is a free fun day for all that starts with activities about 9 a.m. in the morning in the downtown area. We want to warn everyone that might not be attending the parade because they have something else going on that the streets are blocked off. So you might need to plan an alternate route. Also, speaking of parking and driving around, winter parking ban will go into effect on Saturday, December 1st. Okay, that means that there's a winter parking ban. A lot of you that park on the street for convenience or what have you will have to find alternatives. That's not the snow emergency. The snow emergency is much more strict. You should see at major intersections a digital sign highlighting and emphasizing that this will all be taking place. If you have some confusion or would like some further answers, there's a list of streets that are dramatically affected by all this, and that can be seen at www.brockton.ma.us. And that's where you can visit the website and download all this valuable information. Meanwhile, also on December 1st will be the 20th annual Jingle Bell Run. This event is a fabulous, and you can check it out by walking or running. $20 a person, $5 for kids, and all your money goes to the Helping Hands Fund that was started by the Enterprise family, the Fuller family, over 100 years ago. The money afterwards will be dispersed for where people need the services. There's also free hot buffet lunch, prizes for people that dress up in the holiday, theme, and we always have our Grinch, and we also have a lot of elves, so we're really grateful for everyone that does that. This event will be held this year for the very first time at Brockton High School, 470 Forest Ave. So join us when it sign up begins at 12 noon, and we're going to be in the Red Cafeteria, and everyone is welcome to come, all ages. So again, I cannot emphasize enough how great this program is. You can pay by cash or by check. And if you want to find out more about it, you can check out, again, the city's website, because they will be highlighting all the great times. Like the race starts at One, registration's at 12, and there's all kinds of raffle prizes, all kinds of other, how would I say it, prizes, awards, and it is just a plain and simply good time to get you in the holiday spirit. And again, all the proceeds go to those people in need in Brockton and surrounding communities. Okay, something that's really sensitive and always on people's minds and happens at the end of every year is a public meeting and a discussion on the tax levy. This special meeting will be held Monday, December 3rd, at 6 p.m. People are invited to attend. Again, it's Monday, December 3rd, and I should stress this is at the Arnone School, 135 Belmont Street, with plenty of parking, okay? And the agenda here, call the meeting, okay, hearing, and officers return notice. So again, any more questions on that, I can be reached at 774-297-4939 or at aborregard@cobma.us. And it takes me some time, I realize, in some instances to get back to individuals because I try to prioritize something that's really sensitive and something that's going to be a lot more involved. But I'll be happy to answer all your questions. I don't have all the answers, but at least I can go out and find them. Let's talk about the streetlights. The streetlight program kicked off earlier this year, I'm going to say in April when it finally, no, I should say sooner than that. I'm going to say March, that it kicked off, and there were over 8,000 streetlights to address, and plus the schools that were handled. Now there's still about 400 or 500 lights that need to be addressed. We have not forgotten you. It does take more than a minute to get to all of these. Please don't hesitate to call either the Department of Public Works or myself or email me with the poll number if it's not working or if you feel that you've been missed. There are different locations and there are poles that I'm going to call problem poles where there's been some electrical situation that hasn't been able to connect properly and that they're addressing. Okay, meanwhile, if you do see people parked in areas that they're not supposed to be and the plows are going to have trouble getting down, please contact the police at the non-emergency number 508-941-0200. Even if you see people parked before the storm and you know that this is going to be a problem or has been a problem in the past. Again, this number is 508-941-0200. We're really working to get the people off the streets that don't belong on the streets during these snow emergencies and during these winter parking bans. Again, I always encourage people to attend the various public meetings that we have throughout the city, whether it's a finance committee meeting that will be held on Monday, November 19th at 7 p.m. at the Arnone School, or the Board of Trustees library meeting at the Brockton Main Library, 304 Main Street, at 6:30, at Brockton, trustees, Brockton Trustees Library Room, which is across from the offices are down from the circulation desk. So you can find out the needs and concerns that are taking place with the library system, one of the largest in the Commonwealth, or you can find out the various issues that are going to be on the Finance Committee agenda. It doesn't stop there. You can come to the Parks Commission meetings, Parks and Recreational Commission meeting. You can attend a Conservation Commission meeting. By the way, some of these boards are looking for new members. These are governing bodies. This is volunteer positions. Okay? Again, I want to point out that there's all kinds of free and low cost activities going on during the holiday season. We want people to be safe. We also want to let people know that there are plenty of jobs available. They're already hiring for the 2020 census, and you can go right down across the street from City Hall, inside the old Rockton Trust building, to the Mass Hire office, formerly known as BayWib. There's a whole lot happening in Brockton, and I've just scratched the surface. But may all of you, and may this find you safe and warm during the holiday season.